myself that anything and everything in life is achievable.
Now, I've never really made a video like this before. There's so much I've been holding in, therefore spiraling me down this confused and lost path.
Welcome back to another video.
To truly explain how I feel, we have to go back to where it all started. Right before ShootaTime became a thing, I was racing motocross. In the midst of doing what I loved, I fell in love with a new passion of editing videos. I picked up editing naturally as I crossed my passion of listening to music and doing what I loved and just creating a piece of visual art. Fast forward, Fortnite was released and I quickly fell in love with the game. And if you're watching this, I'm sure you knew how it was back in the day. I transferred my skills of editing motocross to editing Fortnite montages of clips my friends and I hit. This is the first sign of detaching a piece of who I was. Although I was still racing motocross and making Fortnite content at the same time, over time I slowly drifted away from racing. Fast forward 5 years and I've created hundreds of Fortnite montages, edits, and content. I've been able to meet so many wonderful creators and do things I've never imagined. You might ask yourself, Shooter, why do you want to quit? Your life seems pimping. To answer that, I'm gonna do whatever YouTuber does and drag it out. Honestly though, I haven't been enjoying Fortnite for the last couple years or so. The game just isn't what I fell in love with originally. Lately, I've been forcing myself to create Fortnite content and always looking at numbers and views, therefore losing my passion for the game. Now, if you're truly passionate about something you make, views will never affect your mindset. You do it because you love it. If you're an OG, you'd realize that I've been trying to pursue more IRL type of content over the years because that's who I am. When phase one started, it was a period in life where I hit a new level of passion and excitement in the things I was doing. It was my opportunity to create the content I truly wanted to do. I went all out in my first video because I wanted to have the craziest first impression when FaZe watched my video. Fast forward, I'm in LA in FaZe's headquarters competing for $1 million.
So surreal.
It was the first time I felt like I was where I was supposed to be in a while. I was able to get to the final three, but that's where the road ends. I told myself after that experience that I wasn't gonna go back home and do the same thing I was doing before phase one. I took that loss and used it as motivation to prove to them that they made a mistake. I broke out of my comfort zone and started making content away from Fortnite montages showing my true potential. The thing about going out of your comfort zone is it takes you down a mysterious unpaved path. And if you aren't strong, it'll take you down a dark path. So to answer the big question, no, I'm not quitting. These past couple months have been hard, but I'm able to take a step back and really analyze my passions and really what I want to do in life. And the one thing I've learned so far,
I just want to make insane videos and do insane stuff in life.
Sorry. It's the hardest rule to follow. I really wish that I could call you. What can I do? You can find.
I booked countless flights and will be traveling across America for the next 20 days. I'll be meeting up with Flea, 12, Shill, and Cuddy in Vegas. From there, I'll be going to LA to create a music video for my boy Ernsto. And lastly, traveling to Florida and going on a cruise to the Bahamas.
Just remember guys, in content creation, there's always gonna be those highs and lows, and it's really what you do in your lows that really define who you are. And for me, I'll never quit up on my dreams.
It's the hardest road to find.